Dear students, we are going to study in 12th class in poetry section, the first lesson, the character of a happy life. In first stanza, how happy is he born or taught that serves not another's will, whose armor is his honest thought and simple truth, his highest skill, his utmost skill. In these lines, the poet says that a really happy man is not dependent on others. He does not work according to the will of others. He is free to do what he thinks proper. He is not slave to anyone. He doesn't need any weapons to protect himself with. Honesty is the only weapon for him. It is his sure defense. He believes in simple truth of life. His simple truth is his best skill. It is his only guide. In second stanza, whose passions not his masters are, whose soul is still prepared for death, untied unto the world with care of princess grace or vulgar wreath. In these lines, the poet prints out the qualities of a happy man. The poet says that a truly happy man controls his passions, anger, worry, jealousy, love and hatred. In fact, such strong feelings are under his control. He is always fearless. He is not afraid of death. It may come to an any moment. He does not care for the favor of the king. He also does not care for criticism of common people. He welcomes both. Such a person passes a happy life. In third stanza, who envies none, whom chance doth raise, or wise, who never understood, the deepest wounds are given by praise, by rule of state, but not of good. Who envies none from chance do threes. अब यहाँ पर in third stanza the poet says that a happy man is a man of pure heart. He is free from such evils like envy and jealousy. There are persons who do not work hard or do not deserve. They only rise in life by chance factor. On the other hand, there are persons who achieve greatness in life by unfair and wicked means. A happy man is not jealous of anyone. Some persons are very wicked. They praise us in our presence but stab in the back. The happy man is open-hearted and plain in his dealings. He understands that false praise is harmful. He doesn't care for the rules of government. He follows the rules of goodness and kindness. In fourth stanza, who consigns is his strong retreat, whose state can neither flatter's feet, nor ruins make accusers oppressors great, who hath his life from rumor's feet. In these lines, the poet says that the life of a happy man is free from rumors. A happy man believes a soul force. In fact, his conscience gives him peace and rest. He keeps balance of mind. He is unaffected by false flattery. He does not care for his ruin. His enemies can get nothing by his loss. Such a person gets true happiness. In fifth stanza, who God doth late and early pray, more of his grace than goods to send, and entertains the harmless day with a well-chosen book or friend. In these lines, the poet points out that a happy man prays to God day and night, later or sooner. There is no selfish motive in his prayer. He prays to God for his grace. He doesn't pray for any gift or any return from him. He does not like to harm anybody. He passes his time in the company of a good friend or a good book. His joys and actions are harmless. In sixth and last stanza, this man is free from servile bands of hope to rise or fear to fall, lord of himself, though not of lands, and having nothing, he hath all. In last stanza, the poet says that a happy man is a man of free nature. He loves freedom. He does not care for rise or fall in life. Success doesn't make him happy and failure doesn't discourage him. He is well balanced. He has self-control. So he is really the lord of himself. His desires are under his control. Such a happy person may be poor in worldly wealth, but he is master of all. The world is true sense. That's all, my dear students. The central idea of the poem. In this poem, the poet describes the qualities of a really happy man. A happy man is honest and truthful. He is the master of his passions. He is not afraid of death. He doesn't care for the love of the prince or the criticism of the common people. He is free from remorse. He depends upon the voice of his conscience. He doesn't care for false flattery. He is not jealous of anyone's progress. He is a God-fearing man and remembers him day and night. He passes his time in company of good book or a good friend. He does not care for rise or for fall in life. He is rich in heart and is lord of himself. Thank you.